Jason Clarke is a researcher for the University of Iowa. He worked his way up from a dishwasher at a lab at the University of Michigan to become a full-time researcher and scientist and joined the University of Iowa staff in 2007.
I do kidney research, molecular biology, in the Department of Pediatrics. So I study normal and abnormal kidney development at the molecular and genetic level. One of the research projects that I work on is a very rare birth defect that I stumbled upon years ago in the mice that I was working with. We were crossing mice together for a certain reason, but we wound up recreating a birth defect that's rare in humans. And when I researched it, nobody was doing research on it. And so here it was, I had the mice that could duplicate it. So we were going to try to find the genetic causes of that birth defect in humans. It's called the bilateral renal agenesis. The human fetuses and babies, they're being born without either kidney. That's a lethal birth defect. And we're really the only research lab in the world. I'm one of the only people in the world that's doing that research right now.
Jason loves his job. He's able to conduct cutting-edge research for the University of Iowa and works in a field he enjoys. But Jason has another passion, one that not many of his coworkers know about.
Pick his knee up, turn his head down. Okay, like a seesaw.
He's the owner and head instructor at Iowa City Brazilian Jiujitsu, which is a form of martial arts. While he spends his days in a lab examining microscopic proteins and DNA, he spends his nights at the gym, on a mat, teaching others about Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, which he's been involved in since he was a kid.
So I've been in martial arts since I was 7. I don't remember life without some sort of martial art in my life, all because of Bruce Lee, probably. I didn't grow up in the best neighborhoods, so there was a necessity for it at the time. And I moved around a lot, so I got beat up a lot. So there was a necessity for martial arts in my life.
Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is a grappling martial art developed in Brazil in the early 1900s. Using various holds, throws, takedowns, chokes, and strikes, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu is a method of self-defense that doesn't rely on strength or power, but knowledge of leverage and anatomy to subdue an attacker.
You'll find that most guys that do Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu tend to be a little bit more cerebral. They need a bit more of a mental challenge as well as a physical challenge. You really get that in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu versus any other martial art.
Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu provides a mental and physical workout. That's why Iowa senior Shane Bertzloff got involved in the sport. He was looking for something to keep him in shape after learning in high school that he couldn't play football anymore.
At the beginning of my senior year of high school, they found a cyst in my jaw that had eaten away all the bone, basically on this side of my jaw. And so they told me I couldn't play football, I couldn't wrestle. And that's when I started doing jiu-jitsu and Muay Thai, which you would think that's like, you know, that sounds pretty stupid to start that after being told no contact. But I could practice and, you know, not compete or not spar and still learn technique.
Shane trained and was eventually cleared to start competing in mixed martial arts bouts. His overall record is 9-4. And he notices a benefit in the classroom after a workout.
When I leave this gym, I feel great, physically, mentally. You know, there'll be days that I don't want to come and I'm tired and I come and I leave and I feel great. I'm able to go and do homework, I'm a little bit more focused.
So I'm gonna work on my grip break real quick.
Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu has also helped Jason outside of the gym. Part of Jiu-Jitsu is the ability to escape a stressful situation, which can help in the lab and in life as well.
It carries over off the mat too, because you get to handle a stressful situation for somebody who's not used to it, but over time they get used to being in that environment and they keep a very cool head. And that will carry over off the mat when you're negotiating for a salary or you're giving a presentation. I have to give PowerPoint presentations in my day job, and it's nervous to get up there and talk in front of people. But when I remember, you know, I can do things that make me nervous and keep a cool head, you know, I do it all the time here.